A lot of people know me for my Hackintosh YouTube channel and build, but fact is I was always Mac user and I always owned more Macs than hacks. In my video called Apple forced me to build the Hackintosh, I said, I'm on Hackintosh because I still believe in Apple and passionately waiting for my Wonder Machine with a sticker on it made by Apple. So go on Apple, release for us finally some reasonable priced modular computers we all want so much. Thank you very much. Count with me, Apple. Sincerely yours, Morgonaut. For my whole life, Apple Evangelist. So finally, after quite 8 years of waiting, Apple really released modular Mac Pro, even though the word reasonable priced may be taken by most people without correct understanding. I have fulfilled my promises and as you can see, I really bought the 2019 Apple Mac Pro. Of course, I had to and I will explain it right now. To own, for example, Power Mac was always extraordinary feeling. I would not say Power Mac users was some privileged group of people, but fact is, Power Macs were in every better music or video production house in hands of artists. So why I didn't bought desktop Mac since 2012? One reason, lack of power and expandability. But the most important reason for me personally was something else. The new Apple computers were missing something in contrast to those Power Macs. I personally call it a good old Power Macintosh spirit. Something was simply missing there, and I didn't have the amazing feeling out of it. Now, with the 2019 Mac Pro, I can feel it again, some inexplicable vibration. I started to help people with Hackintosh builds by one single reason. Apple simply was not able to offer for us, professional users, really as good computer as was the Power Mac G3, G4, G5 or the original cheese grater, especially from years 2009 up to 2012. For most Apple users, the price is not the concern, but for that price they really want stable and powerful computer on which they can rely. Apple users had no other option than to stay on aging hardware, which was simply not able to keep up with higher and higher demands of operating systems and apps, or move to completely another platform. But to move from the best is not a pleasant journey. So to have the ability to stay in the known Apple ecosystem and just build a Hackintosh was a very tempting idea. So my idea was to help to Apple users overcome the period of time until Apple will release again new amazing Mac Pro with up-to-date components and standards and help them to build a perfect Hackintosh. But unfortunately, most of Hackintosh users are not any Apple users for a decade or two or more as me. By my opinion, most of them are just for their whole life Windows users who just want to try macOS or from a jealousy take all advantages of macOS, but not to invest too much to it. Those people will most likely never buy a Mac. And I don't like it. I would like them to try macOS, try Hackintosh, save some money on it, enjoy it, maybe make some money on it, and then buy a regular Mac. And thanks God, I can really see quite a lot of former Windows users switching. So from this point of view, I'd like to give you my suggestion if to build a Hackintosh is the best way for you, or if you should buy the new 2000 Mac Pro, or just something lower spec like iMac. With the coming of the new 2019 Mac Pro, whole situation dramatically changed, and even more polarized people. People say, it's overpriced, it's expensive crap. But in fact, as I will show you in one of my next videos, it's not overpriced, but underpriced. If you would try to buy equally spec workstation from Dell, HP or Lenovo, you would have to pay even more in most cases, and you will not get as many features. And I'm not even talking about the design. Other people say, my 16-core Ryzen 3950X or my 32-core 3970 Threadripper can eat the Mac Pro for breakfast, blah blah, and so on. Sure, if you think you will be more happy with the Threadripper, go for it. Mac Pro or better, any Apple computer as a whole is not for you. I would also find a use case for this AMD Zen 2 32-core monster, but I would never put Windows on it. Most probably I would build a virtualization server of it and it would shine. Hackintosh can be as stable as any real Mac. It just have to be well prepared, well configured and built from precisely chosen components. Advantage of Hackintosh besides its lower price, I can see mainly in low repair costs. You don't need to fear so much. If, for example, your power supply in Hackintosh will burn, you can go to first PC parts shop and buy a new one. If something die in your Mac after 1 or 2 years of warranty or Apple Care, you are out of luck. Repair would cost quite the same as a new Mac. Sure, yes, it's true. You can for half or even third of a price of a real Mac build a Hackintosh with even higher performance. You can build now low-spec Hackintosh, and if you choose your components wisely, you can during years upgrade it more and more to higher GPUs, more powerful CPUs, and so on. Or easily add a high-speed PCI Express SSDs or more disks. Anything you want. You cannot do it with Macs, with the exception of the new 2019 Mac Pro. So if all of the above said resonates with you, then freely build a perfect Hackintosh and be happy. But as I said on the beginning, to own a Power Mac and work on it was always something special. I don't need to explain to smart Apple users why they should buy the new 2019 Mac Pro, they know it already. But still, you can't get anything other like that. It's exceptional. And even if you would buy the cheapest configuration now, you can expand it later even up to the highest end CPUs and GPUs. You can add the amazing Apple Afterburner card, which you cannot use on Hackintosh. Do you need 2, 3, 4 GPUs set up and plenty of Thunderbolt 3 ports? Again, only 2019 Mac Pro can offer it to you. No other desktop workstation has so much expandability options than the Mac Pro. And it's silent, on air, without any fancy water cooling. And of course, no other desktop computer would look so good on your desk, but you should not buy it just for that. PC users with tons of RGB circus lights would not agree with me now, but I don't care. It's a state of mind, soul and heart to be pure good old Mac user who can feel and enjoy the above said good old Power Macintosh spirit in the new 2019 Mac Pro. You have to experience the feeling personally to be able to understand it. Hackintosh does not have any soul. It's just a bunch of metal and plastic. So does not matter if you are that Windows user who just wanna try macOS out of curiosity, or that most likely older guy who loves Macs for his entire life, there's no need to fight against each other. I feel a lot of anger in Hackintosh community, a lot of hate. There's nothing like that in Macintosh world. Buy what you want, what you like, build what you want, build a Hackintosh or buy a Mac. Simply enjoy it. Life is too short to not enjoy every moment, each second. So, despite I bought the new 2019 Mac Pro, nothing has changed in my help to other platforms users or Hackintosh users. I will still provide my personal help to all of you, if you would ask for it. I will still build Hackintoshes for fun and to help you. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Don't forget to join my website morgonout.cloud so you will have always access to all of my videos, tutorials and posts or even to my personal help. Morgonout is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Macintosh and Hackintosh friends.